Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to drag and drop an item from an external tree view component to the React Gantt chart row so that it will be updated to the Gantt task as an additional resource. I hope you have watched my getting started video for Gantt chart. If not, please check the video in the card above or in the description below. I'm going to explain this concept with my existing application where I had configured the Gantt chart with the necessary modules and allocated resources. If you want to know how to allocate the resource to Gantt chart, check the video link in the card above or in the description below. Let me run this application to show you the output page. Here, the Gantt chart is rendered with the local JSON data. Now, I add the tree view component to perform drag and drop operations. To render the tree view component, install its package Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations. After the package is installed, import the component from that package. Then add the tree view component tag. To learn how to create the tree view component, check the documentation in the description below. Now let me show you how to bind data to the tree view component. To specify the data source and mapping fields to the tree view node, I use the field property. Then specify options like data source, ID and text. To the data source option, assign the same JSON object resource details mapped to the resources property in the Gantt chart. Then map the resource ID field from the resource details object to the ID option and resource name field to the text option. Let's have a look at the output. The tree view is rendered below the Gantt chart. To align these controls, I add the CSS class in the div element. You can check the CSS styles defined to this CSS class in the GitHub example shared in the below description. As you can see, the tree view is aligned to the right side of the Gantt chart. To perform drag and drop operations in the tree view component, enable the allow drag and drop property. See here, from the tree view component, I can drag a node anywhere on the output page. Now, I need to update the Gantt chart row with the node dropped from tree view. To update the record, I import the edit and selection modules from the EJ2 React Gantt package and inject them into the Gantt chart services. Those who are not familiar with the editing concept, please check my editing video attached in the card above or in the description below. Now, I include the edit settings property and enable the allow editing option. Notice here, when I double click the tree grid cell in the resources column, the dropdown is shown and I can assign more resources or remove the existing one. Next, to know which tree view node is dropped in the Gantt chart row, I use the node drag stop event. This event will be triggered whenever you stop dragging the tree view node. Then assign the callback method onDragStop to this event. Let me define the callback method now. Here, the main code logic is to update the node in the Gantt chart row. Declare the variable chartRow element and find the row in which the node is dropped using the closest method from the EJ2 base package. In this method, I need to provide two inputs, target element and class selector, to get the closest Gantt chart row. Then specify the selector as eChartRow. After finding the closest Gantt chart row, I need to get the row data. Before doing that, define the ref property in Gantt chart. With this ref property, I get the Gantt chart component instance and access all its public methods. Note that when I drag a node from the tree view and drop it on the Gantt chart row, it is selected. With the selected row index, I get row task data from the Gantt object and store it in a variable selected data. Then I declare the empty array variable resources. I check the resources count in the selected row and push them in the resources variable. Next, I declare another variable record. Using the dragged node data option from an argument, I store the details of the node dropped from the tree view in the record variable. I then push the ID of the node in the resources variable. Now, this variable contains the ID of the existing resource and the new one in an array. We have found the task ID and generated the resources array. Now, I update the Gantt chart row simply by providing these two details in the built-in method updateRecordById of the Gantt chart component. I include the label settings property and assign the resource to the right label option. See here, I drag a node from the tree view and drop it on the Gantt chart row, and the dropped node is updated in that row. I can also drop a tree view node in the Gantt tree grid row by adding two extra logics. I will explain this in detail now. When a tree view node is dropped in the Gantt tree grid row, it will not be selected like a chart row. A separate code is required for that. I declare the grid row element variable and find the record in which the node is dropped using the closest method from the EJ2Base package. I give two inputs, target element and selector, as E row. After finding the closest Gantt tree grid row, I need to select that row. So, I use the getRows method from the Gantt chart, which returns tree grid rows in an array, and from that array, I find the row index of the target element using the indexOf method. Now, I dynamically select the Gantt row by providing this index to the selectRow method. After the row is selected, I can get the row data based on the logic here and update the Gantt chart row. Check here, when I drag a node from the tree view and drop it on the Gantt tree grid record, it will be selected and updated. But the dragged item is still visible. So, I use the class name eDragItem to remove it. Notice here, when a node is dropped on the Gantt tree grid, the row gets updated and the drag item is removed. In this video, we have seen how to drag a tree view node and drop it on the Gantt chart row. You can download a working example of these features from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. There is also a link where you can see if you are eligible for a community license, which gives you free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.